Smoky skies have covered some local communities recently because of two fires, one controlled, the other not.
Some four-legged basketball players made for a fun-filled fundraiser Thursday night, and spring break plans are being made for area community centers.
We'll have these stories and more.
More rainfall tonight across East Alabama, but better weather coming for the weekend. We'll have the complete forecast coming up.
Coming up in sports, one East Alabama school has decided to go a different direction in terms of their football program. Also, one East Alabama basketball player has been named a finalist for Player of the Year. We have more on that in just a minute as EAN Local News starts now.
Segment of EAN Local News is brought to you by Waldrop Manufacturing, metal buildings made right here in Calhoun County.
Hello, we're glad you could join us. I'm Katie Edwards.
And I'm Mike Stedham.
Local officials say the increased amount of smoke throughout the community this week has been caused by a control burn taking place in the White Plains area of eastern Calhoun County. Meanwhile, the U.S. Forest Service has been tackling a separate wildfire nearby on Baines Gap. Rain is forecast for this weekend, which may help extinguish the wildfire in the next few days.
The city of Jacksonville is making it easier for residents to check out contractors before they hire them. The city recently created two new jobs in the building department and is using the added personnel to tackle a common problem, unlicensed contractors. Now, with just one call, residents can determine if a contractor is licensed to work within the city of Jacksonville. And Jacksonville has specific rules for new development. It inspects each project to determine if it complies with those rules. That can leave residents with projects that don't comply with city codes and must be reconstructed or worse. Ben Nunley, a spokesperson for the city, says unlicensed contractors seek work in the city frequently enough to warrant an education program to combat that problem. If you're wondering whether the city where you live can help determine if a contractor is qualified to work there, just check with your local building department. And remember that unincorporated communities are governed by the county, which does have less stringent building guidelines than cities.
The Calhoun County Sheriff's Rodeo is taking place, rain or shine, this weekend at Chuckalaka Park in Oxford. Gates open at 5 p.m. and the rodeo starts at 6. This year's event will feature lots of traditional rodeo action from bull riding to barrel racing. Tickets are still available online at sheriffrodeo.com and they will also be sold at the gate.
When we come back, some difficult players take center court at a local basketball game.
For metal buildings in Alabama and the Southeast, Waldrop Manufacturing is your one-stop source. A Waldrop metal building provides the coverage and protection your investments need. They specialize in carports, RV covers, portable buildings, and storage buildings. Stop paying rent for storage. With Waldrop's price per foot, you can actually save money by buying straight from the manufacturer. Waldrop buildings are guaranteed because Waldrop manufactures buildings with U.S. Steel right here in Calhoun County. Waldrop Manufacturing, serving the entire Southeast. Give them a call today. This segment of EAN Local News is brought to you by Oxford Lumber. Come visit any of our locations in Oxford, Jacksonville, Talladega, and Roanoke.
A version of March Madness came to Muntford Thursday night as two basketball teams had to overcome some of their own teammates just to play the game. The madness was supplied by donkeys, who the players had to ride up and down the court throughout the evening. Dustin Ambergi with Circle A Donkey Basketball supplied the stubborn animals for these games and says each donkey presents a unique challenge for its rider.
Some of them will run and stop, throw their head down, the rider will slide over the top of their head. We call that a duck. Some of them buck. That's pretty self-explanatory. You'll see what we're talking about. Some of them just don't move at all.
Munford Mayor Joanne Fambro says the donkey basketball game was a big success and drew a good crowd for the show.
We haven't had one in our area for many, many years, and everyone's excited about it. The donkeys are out of Tennessee, and we're just really excited about the whole thing tonight. We had food fest right here on the patio before the game, so we're just really excited that we've had such a good turnout.
Renee Stone is the activity coordinator for the town of Munford, and she says the donkey basketball game raised about $3,000 for the town's major project.
We've got a veterans park on the other side of the property that that we're trying to do some fundraisers to get our cement poured for our sidewalks and some park benches, and we're just trying to put it all together so we can jump on it. And we also got a selling brick company through Florida where we're doing memory bricks for anybody can buy a brick. And we've got a website you can contact Town Hall and we give that information out if they'd like to purchase a brick for a veteran or a memory brick for anybody, and then we're going to put it in a different section for the memory bricks.
Historic Main Street Oxford plans to offer free walking tours every Saturday in April. These tours are part of the Alabama Department of Tourism's April Walking Tours Initiative. Four different tours will be offered, exploring diverse themes such as the commercial district, historic homes and architectural styles, local churches, and the Oxford Memorial Garden Cemetery. Each tour starts at 9 a.m. in Simmons Park at 400 Main Street.
When we return, kids in Anniston will have lots of activities next week at the city's community centers.
For over 60 years, Oxford Lumber has been servicing our area, and our customer service has always been our main focus. Our customer service is what sets us apart from anyone else. From the moment you enter, our highly trained staff will treat you like family.
To enthusiastically provide total customer satisfaction within a positive and self-fulfilling employee relations environment. Visit us at any of our four locations or at oxfordlumber.com.
This segment of EAN Local News is brought to you by WM Grocery, located in Heflin, Wadawi, Roanoke, and in Piedmont.
The City of Anniston will offer a variety of activities for youth during next week's spring break. The Wiggins Community Center on West 17th Street will have a spring break day camp Monday through Thursday for children ages 3 through 12. That camp will run from 7 a.m. until 5:30 p.m. daily. The cost is $50 for the week or $15 per day. To sign your child up, contact the Wiggins Community Center's director, Carol Bush, at 256-231-7628 or cbush@annistonal.gov.
Meanwhile, the Anniston Parks and Recreation Department will be offering other activities throughout the week. On Monday from 11 to 3, the South Highland Center will have a bubble bar war, crafts, bingo, and a movie. On Tuesday, the Hodges Center in Golden Springs will have pickleball lessons, a scavenger hunt, and flag football. A field trip to the McWayne Science Center in Birmingham will be offered Wednesday starting at 9 a.m. at the City Meeting Center on Noble Street. And this trip is open only to children who live in the city limits of Anniston, and registration is required. On Thursday, the Youth Sports Complex at McClellan will offer games, a moon bounce, face painting, and a flashlight egg hunt. All of the community centers will be closed next Friday for the Good Friday holiday.
Lots of Easter-themed activities will be taking place this week at local community centers and churches. Heflin Baptist Church is inviting the public to come to its Children's Easter Egg Musical and Easter Egg Hunt Sunday starting at 10. After the service, there'll be carnival-style food such as hot dogs, chips, snacks, cotton candy, and popcorn. There'll be games and, of course, tons of candy to be found during the Easter Egg Hunt. You can bring your kids and enjoy the fun. And I understand there are some other programs.
Yes, as a matter of fact, a lot of people know that we actually record the news here at Parker Memorial down in the studios here, and they have a very egg-citing hunt that's coming up tomorrow. It's not actually an Easter egg hunt. It's more of like a spring festival. They'll have blow-ups and face painting and all kinds of great snacks and prizes.
Any chance they might leave any chocolate Easter eggs around for us for next week?
Well, you never know. Maybe they will. That's 11 to 2 tomorrow.
11 to 2.
If you're interested.
I wonder if it'll be raining during that time.
Let's check with John Holder. He joins us now in the EAN Weather Center to tell us if we'll have any egg-citing weather this weekend.
Mike and Katie, a wet night ahead, but we have much better weather coming for the weekend across East Alabama. We will detail that weekend forecast next.
Since 1993, WM Grocery has been a major part of our local community. WM offers the very best in fresh produce and an outstanding meat department. WM also has many local products not found anywhere else and fresh sushi every day. If you need an event catered, come see Mrs. K at any WM store. Curbside pickup is also available for your online grocery orders. Be sure to download the WM app for all the deals of the week and shopper rewards. Go check them out today at any of their locations.
We take pride in our community and appreciate your business.
Well, with all the clouds and the rainfall today across East Alabama, it held temperatures in check. No sunshine today. We were way below the average, only 62 for the high, below our average of 69. A warm morning, though, this morning, 58 degrees, well above our average low of 45 degrees. Here's the record high temperature for today, 84, the record low, 25. Sun rising on your Saturday morning at 6:42, and we're going to set that sun tonight at 6:57. Weather on your street for a Friday night. Wish I could give you a better forecast, but the rain is going to continue. More scattered showers on Draper Street up in the city of Piedmont tonight. Temperature not changing very much, only about 53 for the low tonight. So the temperature's really not going anywhere, but the rainfall will continue through the evening and the overnight hours. Better weather coming tomorrow. It's going to take a while to get here, though. On Able Street over in the city of Hoax Bluff, morning showers tomorrow. Sunshine possibly by the afternoon. This will be a slow clearing process, but we think we'll get some sunshine in here by later on in the afternoon. Temperature should be warmer than today with a high at 66 degrees. And as we look ahead to next week across East Alabama, a lot of folks are in spring break week. So this is an important forecast. And it's going to be typical March weather coming up on Lenox Avenue, out at McClellan, and all across East Alabama. Highs most days will be in the 60s. We'll have some days that it will be dry, a couple of dry days in there, but a couple of days where we've got some rainfall coming, maybe a day with thunderstorms. All in all, expect typical March weather for spring break week across East Alabama. Let's look at that 7-day forecast. As we said, it's important because of spring break week and also Holy Week coming up next week. Our chance of rain tomorrow, keep in mind, 60%, but that is in the morning. The rain should be out of here by lunchtime tomorrow. The best day weather-wise coming up in the next several days will actually be on Sunday. No rain in the forecast, plenty of sunshine, the high at 70 degrees. I think it'll be a pretty nice day on Monday, but we're going to bring a lot of clouds back into the forecast with a high temperature close to 70 once again. Our next chance of widespread rain will be in here on Tuesday, a 70% chance of rain, maybe some thunderstorms involved, but we do not think this is going to be severe weather. The high once again at 69, a lingering shower on Wednesday, dry weather for the back half of spring break week as we get back into the upper 60s. All in all, not too bad across East Alabama. Let's take a look now at what we expect for the day tomorrow. And this graphic really highlights how the day is going to go. Early in the day, it will be dry in West Alabama. And as we move through today, you're going to see the rainfall moving off to the east. So the deeper we get into the day here on the eastern side of the state, the more we're going to see dry weather. Will we have some rainfall in the morning? Yes, you see the chance of rain here about 40% tomorrow morning, but that should be out of here by lunchtime. High temperatures in the mid-60s. Not a bad Saturday. Just sleep in a little bit, let the rain get out of here, and then enjoy the rest of the day. I'll be back here tomorrow morning with that Saturday forecast. We'll take a look at your Saturday at a glance. I'll also be back here Sunday morning and Monday morning with your breakfast forecast for all of East Alabama. And right now, Namath Pitts is next with sports. Namath.
Thanks, John. One Etowah County school has decided to go a different direction in terms of leadership over their football program. Gaston High School has parted ways with head football coach Alan Beckett. Beckett was appointed head coach in August, just 2 weeks before the start of the season, and he contributed to guiding the Bulldogs to a 2-8 record. The program's outlook has been declining since what was a successful period under Swain Morris from 2013 to 2016, but has since then resulted in a 9-61 record over the past 7 seasons. During this period, the team has secured only one victory or fewer 5 times. This marks Gaston's second coaching search in the past year, with the new hire becoming the third coach within a year. One East Alabama basketball player has achieved many accolades in her career, but she has now been nominated for the Class 1A Player of the Year. Ace Alston has been named a finalist for the Class 1A Player of the Year. Ace Alston has done many incredible things within the past 6 months. She is committed to play college basketball at Alabama. She has won a state championship in volleyball. She has won a state championship in basketball. She was selected Player of the Year in Class 1A for volleyball. She was chosen as the Alabama Gatorade Basketball Player of the Year. She was selected for the North-South All-Star Game, and now she is named a finalist for the Class 1A Girls Player of the Year. The winners for each classification will be announced at a luncheon banquet on April 16th in Montgomery. Ace Alston will be joined by other finalists, Sarah Davis from Shoals Christian and Kayana King from Skyline. That's it for EAN Local Sports. Let's go back over to Mike and Katie.
Thanks for the update, Namath, and we thank you for watching today.
You can find us here online every weekday on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook, or on our website. Just go to the platform of your choice and watch our news, sports, and weather content whenever it's convenient for you.
You have a great weekend, and we'll see you back here Monday for your news on your schedule.